for attention with them, you know. And then it's a flipping of the script, you know, in a sense, because I'm not adamant about attention. I'm adamant about truth and justice. I have vehement desire and zealous for justice and righteousness and fairity, you know. You know, things that's fair, equal measures, just measures, not unjust measures and scales. Harassment, it costs a lot, you know. It costs money to organize harassment, you know. The only way, you know, it's not rocket science, you know. And if you don't pay, if somebody not being paid, you know, for the organized harassment for their part, because all involved have a part. They either, if they're not getting paid monetary gain for it, they're brainwashed into thinking and working towards some kind of satanic unjust cause. And they think that the cause is just because they brainwashed and deluded into thinking so, you know, which is why they continuously act and so adamant and so passionate about committing these evil atrocities against a targeted individual, you know, because that's the way they've been brainwashed and conditioned and programmed into thinking, you know, when in reality, the ones they should be opposing are the ones, are the very ones that are that first attempt to set out or put orders out, you know, to oppress somebody that's of the light, and somebody that loves the Lord and follows the Lord. You know, it's satanic. Just like in the Bible, you know, when the Lord himself was on earth, you know, the only way like I said in numerous quarters, the only way Satan can operate is just like how a fish is in water. You know, he can only operate deception, you know, has to be deception or confusion. It can't be just that order when he works, because, you know, he's a author of confusion, you know. God is not. So in order to you know, produce these evils, he has to have a measure of confusion and deception, you know, in the air, in the atmosphere. And then that's easy to do. The more status and influence you have in society, think about it. You know, the more influence you have in society, the more range you have and the more reach you have. You know, so just think, if I'm some kind of wicked king of the leader, and you know, I'm making all this, you know, noise about, you know, things that's unfruitful, you know, that's embracing evil, Satan. And that's gonna satisfy my love of money. And then I see, you know, I see somebody else, you know, with more potential that I see doing more than me, than the, when I have twice as much as them, you know, and naturally, you know, that's a target, that's a threat. So, just like in the Bible, you know, the only way they was able to take Jesus was because they had to split the crowd. You know, they had to promote this false stuff to try to make it like a word against word scenario, or to make things to be what they was not, you know. The fact still remained that Jesus ain't never did anything wrong, but yet he was crucified. They said, send up Barabbas. You know, they wanted Barabbas, a known criminal or whatever, you know, at the time. You know, that's who they wanted to release back onto their streets. You know, who knows what kind of evil they could have committed already against their people, you know. That's who they wanted. They said, crucify him. Why? They said crucified. So, as followers of Christ, we're going to deal with the same type of persecution. You know what I mean? No servant is greater than the master. You know? No servant is greater than the one that sent. Jesus said, they persecuted me, they shall persecute you. They obeyed me, and they shall obey you. you have done for the least of these you have done to me. Those humble themselves like children are the greatest in heaven. Without holiness, no one is to see God. Blessed are the peacemakers, for they shall be called children, sons of God. Praise the Lord, the mark of your calling in Christ Jesus. Eternalize these things, you know. Say, keep wisdom, man. Mercy and kindness, you know, around our necks. Never forsake them. Never, you know, write the words of the Lord in the tablet in our hearts. Never forget. Turn away from the Lord. Nothing too hard for the Lord, you know. All things work for the good of those who love the Lord, called according to his purpose. We have not been given a spirit of fear. Sound mind. These things that God still build us with, you know. Not to mention hate, envy. That's not God's spirit. Flesh. Flesh is weak, but the spirit is willing. No matter how far from the cross you want, never too late to turn back around. Stop. All decisions separate us and determine. faith is in the spiritual and his flesh is temporary, which is why most of these recordings gravitate towards the spiritual realm, you know, because that's ultimately where everyone is going to end up, you know, in one way or another. It's my hope that, you don't be in hell, that nobody be in hell, you know. I make up my mind, I'm not going to hell. I'm going to do what I got to do to get to heaven. I would say, cut your head off, save your body. Now what you gotta do, do it. Don't be pulled into the pit. There's definitely something down there waiting on you. That's what the worst punishment be. Can't be for the cross and turn against the cross. Forsake the cross. They embrace something that you know is false. After knowing and being shown the truth and the light of the gospel and the gloriousness of God, choosing to forsake the Father knowingly and embrace something that's unfruitful, something that's false, something that's destructive. Something that's satanic. No, that's abominable. Worst punishment for the teachers. Instead of to glorify the Lord for which he was given. You know this. And the thing about it, you know, when you're serving the Lord, it's not boring. You know, it's never boring. Like, it's not bland. It's not dry. It's, you know, you die in corner pleasure, but it's much more that fulfills you. You get much more fulfillment in the things that you do. You know, that's aside from embracing the secular reality of the world. You know, a society and the darkness of society. There's life without that, you know. In fact, there's more to life than carnal pleasures, you know. Contrary to belief, you know, or contrary to perception of anything that's still, you know, captive of the darkness in the hands of Satan. The dirtiness of the world and coldness of society.